Cocktopus Prime with the Cooter Report on the Skeptic Fence Show.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna bag me some horn cookers tonight.
Let's see who we got this week.
The Bible asks this question: whose report do you believe? And the biblical answer is we believe the report of the Lord. As a matter of fact, in another place in Scripture, it says, let God be true and let every man be a liar. It's the Bible's way of saying that when men are saying things that contradict God's word is accurate and men are wrong in spite of their education, in spite of their expertise, in spite of their philosophy. Whomever and whatever contradicts the word of God is not correct.
He says, whoever contradicts the word of God isn't correct. So I guess bats are birds, rabbits chew their own cud, mustard seed is the smallest seed in the world, the moon creates light, there's a roof or a firmament around or above the earth, and that unicorns exist, obviously. Because if you disagree with the word of God, then you are incorrect. So obviously all this shit you thought you knew is wrong. Just throw it right out the fucking window and trust some fucking ancient book that has been retranslated over and over again from the scribblings of some fucking ancient goat herders. Makes a shitload of sense, right?
The reason that I bring this up is because every day we pick up headlines that give reasons for situations in our world, and many times those situations have nothing to do with the report.
And this motherfucker has the nerve to say, well, many times there are reasons given to explain a report that have nothing to do with the report. You mean like the Bible, you fucking moron, trying to tie the Bible and into everything? I mean, the motherfucker that just said that is about to say this. This is someone who says many times reasons are given to explain a report that have nothing to do with it. And now listen to his explanation.
For example, we hear that all of the weather events that are taking place in the world today are a result of environmental impact of global warming, that emissions from factories and sorts of things are the reason why there's mudslides and the reason why there's hurricanes and tornadoes and earthquakes and all of these various situations. That's incorrect.
And when science tries to explain maybe why we're having more of these severe weather effects lately, now that we have, like, you know, the ability to do so, he says, no. that's incorrect. That's false. Because it's obviously much more likely that Jesus is causing the tornadoes and the mudslides and the fucking hurricanes and the earthquakes, right? Jesus. Because science is hard.
The Bible says that whenever we approach the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, that there would be strange weather patterns. Jesus said this in Matthew, the 25th chapter. So we have a decision to make. Do we believe what an environmentalist group says and choose to live in a world where we're attempting to make everything as clean in the air as possible? Or do we believe what the Bible says, that these things were going to happen, and that rather than try and clean up all of the air and solve all the problems of the world by eliminating factories, we should start to tell people about Jesus Christ, who is to return.
Exactly when have there not been something you could call strange weather patterns? I mean, any time you have like a tornado or whatever, you could call that a strange weather pattern. Any time. I'm not going back thousands of years to a bunch of people who knew nothing to get all of my information. You and your ilk can go ahead and fucking, like, get off on that retarded shit. Being so proud of being ignorant, like, they tried to fucking teach us, but we didn't want to learn. Ha ha! Gotcha! Go Jesus! I mean, is there anything stupider than ignoring all of the current science in order to protect your, like, oh-so-outdated and fragile faith? Is there anything more pathetic? Or in this case, I guess, entertaining. I mean, the sad part is that this motherfucker actually gets paid. The guy that says, He makes money off preaching about the Bible, and this is the guy that says the Bible is always right, and if man disagrees, man is wrong. Well, it says that's a nice watch there. It says that you should give that away to you know, Jesus said get rid of that shit. You shouldn't have any material possessions. It's harder for a rich man to get into heaven than it is for a camel to fit through the eye of a needle. Someone's not reading the whole Bible. Someone's making up explanations in their head. I guess that makes you incorrect by your own fucking line of reasoning. And what's this asshole's problem with, like, living in a clean world or trying to make it as clean as possible? He's, like, saying that, like, it's a bad thing. He's like, do we listen to the scientists and try and live in a clean world or Jesus? So, in summary, it is for ignoring all current scientific information in order to protect your outdated and fragile faith that you win, Matthew Hagee, the Cooter Award for being the dumbest horn kicker I can find. I believe this is like the third or fourth Cooter Report I've done on you. You seem to get in here quite often, and it's because you do such a good job of mimicking Cooter, who doesn't understand causality, causation, correlation, any of that shit. Just like, and that's the same way you are. Until next time, Coctopus out.
Cooter!